Hello and welcome back to Functional Analysis. And as always, I want to thank all the nice people that support the channel on Steady or PayPal. Today's part 5 is about Cauchy sequences and complete metric spaces. And as promised in the last video, we start here with an example. Our metric space has as a set the interval from 0 to 3 with the normal metric for the real numbers. Hence, this is something you already know. What you also know is that the subset 0 to 3, which is the whole space, is a closed set inside this metric space. For example, you could argue that the complement, which is the empty set, is clearly open. Or you can use the fact from the last video, where you consider any convergent sequence with members from the subset. Being a convergent sequence means it has a limit, which we call x tilde, and of course it has to lie in x. What we proved last time was now the set is closed if the limit is also in the subset. Of course, here you see immediately that this is true because the subset 0,3 is the whole space X. Now, a question that often arises with such an example is the following. What is about a sequence 1 over n? Clearly, this is a sequence in X. First member is 1, next one is 1/2, and so on. You see all the members are positive, so they lie in this interval. And the distance between two members of the sequence, so maybe let's call them xn, xm, this number gets smaller and smaller when x and m get larger and larger. So we could write it in this way, but the important thing is that you see that you get closer and closer to something with the sequence. However, still, it does not converge. For our example, this is easy to see, because the only possible limit this sequence could have in the real numbers would be the number 0. However, 0 is not an x. There is no number 0 in our universe here. In summary, we found a metric space which owns a sequence which should converge, but there is no point in the space where the sequence leads to. Therefore, one could say there is a hole in the space, but we will say the space is not complete. So now we have to give a formal definition for a complete metric space. First, for a given metric space XD, sequences that fulfill this property here are called Cauchy sequences. More concretely, this means for all epsilon greater than 0, there exists an index capital N in N such that for all indices nm greater than this index N, we have that the distance between the members xn, xm is arbitrarily small, so less than epsilon. So this is the actual meaning of this limit before. What you should be able to show now is, if you have a convergent sequence, then this thing is also fulfilled. A Cauchy sequence is therefore always a generalization of a convergent sequence. So you see, there's no limit, there's no x tilde in the definition of a Cauchy sequence. Hence, it would be much nicer working with this definition than working with the one for the convergent sequences. However, we already know the problem. This does not work in general. Now, the nice spaces where this actually works, we call complete. Therefore, we say here, all Cauchy sequences converge. In other words, something like above can't happen then. And of course, you already know how to fix the example above. We could change the set X. When we include 0 and 3, then of course now the space is complete. You might already see the general result here, because we consider metric spaces coming from the real numbers R with the same metric as R. Therefore, as long as the set X is closed in R, which means in a metric space RD in this case, then what we get out is a complete metric space. However, that is just because we already knew that RD is a complete metric space. You might already feel that this should work in general, and you are correct. If you have a complete metric space, you can form new ones just by considering the closed subsets with the same metric. However, that's something we can prove later. Let's first look at another example. Now, we don't change the set, we still consider the interval 0 to 3 where we exclude 0 and 3, but now we change the metric. And I want to choose the discrete metric. So this is what we defined in part 2 as a discrete metric. Now my claim is, this is also a complete metric space. Indeed, that's not hard to show, we just choose an arbitrary Cauchy sequence here. Then we know this whole thing here holds for all epsilon, so that I can just take 1. And I want to have epsilon as 1/2. Then we know there is a capital N, such that all indices that are greater than n fulfill this one. This means that the distance between xn and xm is less than epsilon, or in other words, less than 1/2. However, now we see in the definition of the metric that less than 1/2 is only possible in the bottom case. Therefore, the distance is indeed 0, which again means that xn is the same as xm. So please note, this works for almost all indices here, only finitely many before could be different. Hence it tells you that the sequence is indeed constant after the index n. Okay, maybe let's look at the graph where we have here the indices and here the space x. At the beginning, the sequence is allowed to do something. However, the value it reaches with the index n is then fixed for the entire time of the sequence. So you could say this is quite a boring sequence because it does not change anymore. However, for such a sequence, it's easy to show that it is a convergent sequence with the limit x tilde as exactly this constant in the end. And now we have seen that these are indeed the only possible convergent sequences in a discrete metric space. And of course, we have also shown that this one is indeed a complete metric space. Okay, maybe that's good enough for today. In the next video, we will look at some important complete metric spaces. So I hope I see you there, and goodbye.